getting ready to go to Trincomalee. We have to head to the bus stop. I believe 4-hour bus ride.
I hope it's 4 hours.
We hope it's 4 hours.
Don't know.
But the buses don't start until 1 o'clock, so we actually have time, and checkout is at noon. So we have more than enough time. And hopefully the weather's nice when we get there. It looks like it's nice, so we should be good for the time. The Sri Lankan Civil War started in 1983 up until 2009. It was a 26-year-long war between the Tamil and Sinhalese people of Sri Lanka, where it is estimated from 80,000 to 100,000 people lost their lives. Fought between the Liberation Tigers of Tamil and the Sinhalese-dominated Sri Lankan government, it is stated to have started because the Sri Lankan Tamils were tired of the discrimination against them by the government. It caused significant hardship for the entire population. It was a very conflictive war with the LTTE, labeled as terrorist, and the Sri Lankan government accused of human rights abuse and violations. I actually found this very interesting because compared to what we have going on in America right now, it is nothing compared to what has happened here. Every Sri Lankan millennial grew up in the middle of a civil war that was started for the very same reasons why we protest in the US right now in 2020. That's like me being born into a war and it only ending when I turned 12. In the south of Sri Lanka, you will find more Sinhalese people compared to where we are headed now in the north, which is more Tamil controlled. But I honestly have to say I have so much more respect for the Sri Lankan people, Tamil and Sinhalese alike, for enduring that hardship and coming out on the other side stronger people and a stronger country. We met at Trincomalee, right in our room. Very disappointed actually, because we were supposed to be in a room on the beach. There's no Wi-Fi. No breakfast included, we thought. Since we're paying 3,000 rupees, pretty much like $15 a night, no breakfast and not the room that we asked for. But we've been traveling for like 7 hours already and it's nighttime now. So we're tired, so we're just gonna just stay and deal with it. But I believe tomorrow we're gonna change locations because none of this is what we asked for.
Stay here for 1 month.
And the entire hotel, maybe 4 other guests here. And so it's very quiet, calm. As you saw earlier, it's large. We have the pool, we have the ocean there. And the kitchen downstairs, we can use anytime we like. And it's humongous with everything we need. What we are paying for the entire month is 325 USD. We got a good deal and it's right next door to Mimos where we were earlier. The place we had before, we were not happy with that at all. It was not what they said it was. And we actually stayed in the nicer room. Mm-hmm. And it was bad. It was horrible. So we stayed one night and we were out in the morning. And luckily we found this place down the road.
When we're coming from Kandy to Trincomalee, we come closer to Trinco. We saw more military bases and checkpoints and a lot more than what we have seen before.
I guess this side of Sri Lanka, more north, is Tamil controlled versus the south where Sinhalese controlled. And actually what we've noticed so far, they're kind of less friendly on this side.
Mm-hmm. It's a different vibe.
It's a different vibe, for sure. South versus north of Sri Lanka. And they're more serious. And obviously that's not all Tamil, because we know a lot of Tamil people that are very cool. But nonetheless, still beautiful. Still beautiful country. We still meet friendly people all the time. We actually got invited to one of the staffs here, his son's first birthday.
Yep.
And that was very interesting and very cool and a lot of food. So we had a good time with that. When we first got here, about the first few days, we went shopping and we saw this really cool fish market. It was hype. There's people everywhere yelling, selling all kinds of local fish. Since we're right on the ocean, there's a huge variety of fish.
It's the first time I saw like the styrofoam boxes with lots of crushed ice in there, and yeah, it's like a proper professional wholesale fish market. Probably they ship to China or Colombo to more high-end restaurants, maybe all over the world.
We're actually going to show you guys that market next, so absolutely stay tuned for that. And don't forget to like and subscribe. Right on the bottom, you see it. And keep up with everything. What's up, guys? Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel, because you will be uploading new episodes every week. And make sure that you hit the bell so you receive notifications when we decide to upload randomly.